Let's continue. The insertion order. Let's say that you inserted the following keys in the dictionary: 20, Mustafa, 30, 2, 2, 7 in a tuple, and 30. There is what we call insertion order. We inserted in order 20, Mustafa, 30, 2, 7, and 30. Now, does dictionary preserve this order? There is a history for this question, and the history would be before 3.6 and 3.6 in CPython and Python 3.7. The important part here is, starting from Python 3.7, the language specification itself ensure that the keys will be in exactly the same order as the insertion order. So if you try to print the dictionary.keys, they must be in this insertion order. And this sometimes in some problems would be of very interest. In a few cases, you might really care about the insertion order. Now observe here, there is a difference between an insertion order and value order. For example, if you have a value like 10 and 5, you say, let's say you inserted in the dictionary 10 and 5, then the insertion order is 10 and 5, but the value is ordered from small to large is 5 and 10. 99% of the cases, you actually need the value order in the industry, not the insertion order. But sometimes it happens that you need the insertion order. Now, should I depend on the insertion order of Python 3.7? This is a bit complicated concern. If you are using the language itself, you are in the safe side. But observe that it is still not that common culture in the community. There are might be some of the packages that still like code themselves as if they don't depend on that social order. It might be problematic. I think I have some links in the slide here for you to read if you have interest. The current advice is don't depend on the idea that the insertion order is preserved. It's good to know about that, but don't depend on it. You don't know what might happen to your code or how what kind of packages you might call. You aren't sure. So anyway, it maybe after like 10 years, things would be more stable. And by the way, there is what we call ordered dictionary, which in the past, like I think since Python 2, used to be there to maintain the insertion order idea. If you wanted to make use of your code and depend on the insertion order, that's okay. However, at least try to guarantee that your project will run using Python 3.7. If your team, for any reason, switch it to an earlier version, it will be broken. Unless 3.6 in CPython, because they already started that this idea. What else? The keys. Let's play with them. We have here a dictionary, and these are the dictionary.items returned for you like a object that you can iterate over it. Every element is a tuple of key and value. So one of the very common ways to iterate over dictionaries is as following. You write for key and value, which is matching the tuple here in dictionary items, then you print them. This is one of the very, very, very useful dictionary keys functionalities. If you printed the dictionary.keys itself, it will be this dictionary object of these items. If you use the list over the dictionary.keys, then remember list constructor needs something that it can iterate over it. It will convert for you the list to the key dictionary keys to a list here. You can also iterate with a key for key and dictionary key. There's one advantage for this style only. Let's say that you would like to iterate on the keys, but sort it by the value. So one way is you create a list here, and then you sort it and use it. This isn't like the best efficient way. You can get the list, a list.sort, but like as a shortcut here, you can say for key and sorted list of dictionary of keys. However, there is also an easier way to do that. If you just wrote for key in sorted dictionary, it also is going to replace for you all of that in a single line of code. Now you can use the key dictionary of key to get the values. So again, this is what you typically will use. Unless you need some sorting or reversing for the dictionary keys, then you need another way. Back to the list versus the dictionary. When can I use list and when should I use the dictionary? Remember that the list is an ordered sequence and can be indexed and can be sliced. However, in the dictionary, the order is mainly about the insertion, preserve it, and it's mainly a bunch of key and values. If you have something that is really should be trapped between 0 and n minus 1 in terms of densities, the list is going to be the most efficient case. If you have keys that might be very flexible, might be strings, might be whatever, then the key value style is the way to go. The shallow copies, it's very important, like many things in Python so far, when we take a copy, we are actually making a shallow copy. Let's say we have an employee object and a list object. And the dictionary here has an object, the list, and have the object m here as part of the values. So we can print them. If you try to pop an item from the list or change the ID of the employee, this is going to be reflected in the original dictionary itself. So the values will be changed. Observe here, if you try to write here list equal 5, list equal new value, this will not affect the dictionary because this is a new address in the memory assigned to the list. But if you try to play with the list itself, like bobbing an item or appending an item, it will change the list. In a very similar way, if you just wrote dictionary.copy, this again is a shallow copy. The objects are the same. That's all.